Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for April the 22nd of 2020, well, it is titled Planet Earth at Twilight. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image taken back in 2001 by the International Space Station. So what we see here is a portion of the planet Earth, and we're looking here at the dividing light between night on the left-hand side and day on the right-hand side. Now, the dividing line between that is called the Terminator, so the Terminator between night and day. And what we note on the Earth is that it's not a very distinct region. It does not go directly from night to day, that there's a gradual change where it goes from complete darkness on the left-hand side to something in between towards the central portions and complete daylight on the other side, on the right-hand side. And that is because the Earth has an atmosphere. The Terminator on the moon would be a nice distinct line that it would go from day to night. And were you on the moon, as the sun set, it would go pretty much directly from nice and bright to completely dark. Now here, what we see with the atmosphere, we can actually see some of the atmosphere here. And you can see some of the upper layers of the atmosphere off to the right-hand side towards the top of the image, where you can see that bluish glow up above the Earth itself. And those are the upper layers of the atmosphere that we see. Now, the atmosphere of the Earth does not have a distinct edge to it either. It just kind of fades out as it gets more and more diffuse as you get higher and higher. And in fact, there is still some atmosphere up at the level of the International Space Station. Not a lot, not enough to completely slow down or bring the space station back down, but enough to cause a little bit of drag with it. And that happens to very, very low-flying satellites that eventually they will be brought back down to Earth by frictional forces as the satellite passes through the atmosphere of the Earth, the very tenuous upper atmosphere. And as you get further and further down, the atmosphere gets thicker and thicker. And now when you get down to the troposphere, where we see all of the clouds in the image here, the atmosphere is again much thicker until it gets down to the level that we are used to around sea level, and in fact the concentration of atmosphere that we need to be able to breathe. And in fact, in some of those clouds here, you can see the red color associated with the sunset there, and that is the sunlight being scattered through the clouds, and the red light is the one that actually makes it through when the sunlight is coming at a great angle like this. Then the sunlight is, the bluer lights are scattered and appear to come from all over the place, and the red light passes through, illuminating those clouds, giving us the reddish color that we associate with sunrise or sunset. So that was our picture of the day for April the 22nd of 2020. It was titled Planet Earth at Twilight. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Planet Earth at Night. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.